Is today starting to be really interesting?
Cold water?
Absolutely. And it takes absolutely no time for that cork to go down. I don't know if bluegill can be called slaunch donkeys or not, but this one is. It's keep coming. Holy smokes! The governor has signed a stay-at-home order effective Monday, tomorrow, through the 24th of April, I believe. However, I have to thank Governor Parsons for including in this order the provision that you can do outdoor activities. So hello, here we are on a rather chilly day. Overcast, not too bad, a little bit of wind. Barometer looks good. So we're here today, I'm gonna go to one of my favorite little ponds here in central Missouri, and I'm gonna do an assessment of what's biting. And as soon as I see the switch is flipped on, that's when Lorraine and I will get back at it. As soon as I'm ready, let's go. The nice thing about walking down these trails in the springtime is they're not overgrown yet. The hike is much easier. Okay, folks, we're in uncharted territory here today, and that I have never seen this pond at this level. The overflow is underwater, and if the wind doesn't interfere and you listen real carefully, there's quite a bit of water going out the overflow. So this is either gangbusters or bust. Hopefully the fish did not get the governor's memo and they are out and about doing recreational activities. Come get it. Are you growing into your ears, bub? Show me your spin. There you go. Good spinning. Good spinning. Good boy. Is an authentic DD. Your first victim was understandably right over there by that tree, just a few feet out from the bank. Nice fat fish. Fluky though, look at that. Bluegill are supposed to take care of those flukes. All right, so bluegill and snails start defluking these bass. Okay, so what is a Z-Bug? This is another little modification of a TRD craws, a little section of a TRD craws. And unlike the Tinky Dinky, where the section is just wrapped around on itself, the little orange flash makes this more like a crawdad. Okay, after getting a couple of what I call Tinky Taps, little dippy 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 dippy, I just gave him a little Z-Bug. And I think this is a bluegill. Because it's going woody woody woo. Do I know you little rascals in here or not? Wow, that's a real pretty bluegill. I might keep them today if they're 9 or above. Okay, this beauty is 8.5, a little over 8.5. So you get to swim another day, girl. Catch you later. And the thing about Z-Bugs is you just throw them in. And the fish grab it and run off before you even do anything. Come on. Hello. Look at you. This beautiful crappie is 12 inches long. Beautiful. Getting a little corky up in here. Look at that beautiful bluegill. That's alarmingly gorgeous. Let's put her on the board. About 8 3/4. We're looking for the 9s. You get to have some babies this spring. See ya. Where's my cork? Oh, they're putting on a show today. My goodness. Isn't that pretty? Right at 8 1/4, between 8 1/4 and 8 1/2. So if you're using a real small jig like this for bluegill, make sure you got some needle-nosed style pliers. All right, girl. Bye. Well, I busted off my Z-Bug on a stump. This is another thing that I made. These minnows are made out of cut-down TRD minnows. TRD minnows are about 4 inches long. These are cut almost in half, and then cut in half lengthwise. And the Z-Bug has the tentacle tail, see? And the minnows have the little flippy tail. But I've had really good luck with these before, so let's give them a try. You may have noticed it's the lack of froggies. Probably because yesterday it was only in the 30s. But it's supposed to warm up pretty nicely this week. So I suspect everything will get hopping here pretty quickly. 13 1/4, almost 13 1/2. That's pretty good. See you later. Hello. Aren't you beautiful? Good grief. Look at the shoulders on these bluegill. 8 1/2, between 8 1/2 and 8 3/4. All right, see you later. That one would be a sandwich right there. Hits keep coming. Holy smokes. My Lord have mercy. Good grief. I'm speechless. This amazing bluegill is right on 10 inches. Now that is a heifer. I gotta get your picture. Don't go away. I can't even put my hand around this thing. This is gigantic. There's a dandy. Gee whiz. I should start a bluegill modeling agency. Beautiful. Absolutely stunning bluegill. 9 1/4. That's why I just love this pond. There's a sandwich and a half, sweetie. Get the grease. Welcome aboard. Okay, Lorraine, do you recognize your froggy bank over here? That's where these big girls are hanging out, right over there. This is also a very nice bluegill. And it comes in right at between 9, about a little over 9. I'm so glad these big bluegill did not get the quarantine memo. Okay, I just sanitized my hands. Let me attempt to succinctly summarize this shindig. Number one, fishing was pretty good, all things considered. The pond today was actually pretty good, but it wasn't red hot. So you can imagine how good that pond is when it's fully turned on. The reason I can state that it wasn't red hot, I didn't catch a single fish anywhere along the dam. And in some areas of the pond, nothing, absolutely nothing. And the crappie weren't biting all that great. So the best is yet to come on the pond we fished today and on several others. So I was very happy with the fishing today. It turned out really well. And so therefore, I'll just say adieu to you from here in central Missouri and from our house to your house. God bless, be safe, and we're going to get through this coronavirus thing. All right, Rudy, let's show the elevator. Come on. Okay, this is the elevator. This is how Rudy gets up on the couch.